Hello, my name is Jeff Hall, and I'm a biologist with the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission. We're here in the longleaf pine ecosystem, natural habitat for the gopher frog, one of the most imperiled amphibians in North Carolina. An understated, medium-sized, brown, bumpy frog, they're a fascinating species with many unique character traits. The gopher frog is state endangered in North Carolina due to its life history and habitat requirements. Tied to both upland longleaf pine forest as well as isolated wetlands, gopher frogs are real habitat specialists. Due to fire suppression as well as outright loss of longleaf habitat, the gopher frog is now found in only a few places in our state. They also require wetlands that dry periodically. They don't have to dry annually, but they do have to dry down every so often. That's because the species doesn't really like to lay its eggs in ponds that have fish in them. Outside of the breeding season, which is in the late winter, early spring, gopher frogs live in stump holes in the longleaf pine uplands. They can travel long distances across these landscapes, sometimes moving several miles from stump holes to ponds. Frogs remain in the ponds for about 2 months for breeding. Females deposit egg masses on grassy stems in the pond. Then the adults leave, heading back into the woods. The eggs left behind take approximately 1 to 2 weeks to hatch. After hatching, it takes tadpoles another 3 to 5 months, depending upon weather conditions, to reach metamorphosis and become juvenile frogs. These small frogs then hop out of the pond and head into the uplands to look for their own stump holes. In addition to the challenges of habitat loss, young frogs also face the challenge of invasive red imported fire ants. To try and help gopher frogs, the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission, along with our partners, are using a variety of strategies. Habitat restoration is one of those strategies and might involve adding prescribed fire to the landscape or restoring ponds by removing overstory trees or heavy duff layers that have built up. In addition to pond restoration, another way to help the gopher frog is to try to increase the number of frogs that are on the landscape. One of the ways that we do this is through a Head Start program where we raise eggs in captivity up to metamorphosis. To do this, we search wetlands during the time that gopher frogs are breeding, looking carefully for egg masses. Once found, we carefully collect a small portion of each mass. These eggs are then taken to one of our partners, such as the North Carolina Aquariums or the North Carolina Zoo. There, they are raised up to metamorphosis, and then we mark them by injecting them with a special type of marking system so that we can later identify if it's an animal that was head started. We then release them back at the sites of capture near the edges of breeding ponds. Our hope is that these juveniles will survive to become breeding adults in 2 to 3 years. We have not completed intensive surveys to determine how many of those animals might have returned, but we have at least in one instance recaptured an animal that was part of a Head Start effort from 2011, which is the first year that we began head starting. This lets us know that we're at least having some success. Although it is a challenging situation, I'm hopeful that our efforts will lead to a more secure future for the gopher frog. And maybe, just maybe, the snoring chorus will be a little louder this year.